Everyone, welcome back to my channel. This my video is different from my other videos that you have been watching for since long, because most of my videos were about beauty review of the beauty products, or some of them are about food or travel. But this video that I have been planning to do since long is the with my book review video. And might be you don't know that I am a very avid reader, and I love to read, but very less often that I'm able to give my review. A few of the blogs I have written as a book review, but not much. Today I thought to share my views about this book, and that is 100 Journeys by Umar Zafarullah. It is a stories of my fatherland. This is the book that I have read. It's been quite some time that I have read this book, and the special feature of that book, or the special memory that is attached to this book, is that in an event we got the opportunity to talk to the writer himself, and discussed the matters related to the book, or the discussed in the background of the book, and we get to know the thought process of the writer as well. And it was a wonderful meeting and arranged by our company, Content Creators, and it was a lovely meeting with the writer. Being living in Lahore, alhamdulillah, I got these opportunities quite often to meet with writers of even international repute, and have a one-on-one chat with them as well, regarding their thought process, regarding their style of learning, and the matters or the topics that they have selected for their books to write. So this particular book, that is 100 Journeys, it's a very intriguing, that most of the time we read that it is the stories of the motherland, but here the writer has aptly described it as a stories of a fatherland. It's really intriguing, because I do have a very lovely relationship with my father, and I owe a lot to my father, and I hope you all owe a lot to your fathers. I really like the title of this book, and there is a special note from the writer as well for me: Tayyiba, Mulla and Military and Beyond. The future is yours, good luck. Because we have a huge discussion on these topics, and in the particular background of Pakistan and the scenario that we have in Pakistan, and the role of mullahs and military in our country. After that discussion, it is like you can say prayer from Mr. Umar Zafarullah for me, I guess, and I really like it that he write this on his while signing my copy. Little background of the writer. I want to tell you that Umar Zafarullah is a mechanical engineer with a degree from Yale University, Connecticut, USA, and is an executive in a Fortune 500 company. He belongs to Gujarat and lives in Lahore. He regularly contributes article to the news, that is a local newspaper here, but international newspaper it is called, because that is the most read daily in Pakistan. He is married to a doctor, Saira, and has two children, Heather and Maya. And he dedicated this book to Maya, his daughter. And this book is printed at Thompson Press, India, Faridabad, and it is published by Rupa Publications, India again, and at New Delhi, and it's the work is fiction, of course, and the names, characters, and the places and incidents are either the product of author's imagination or are used fictitiously, and any resemblance to any actual person, living dead, is coincidental. Okay, so if you can see the contents here, there is a letter that is a prologue, and then policy, then the chapter is family. It is divided into different chapters, and then 100 journeys is there, and then war by any other name, and then trust me. So these are the chapters, and there are subtitles as well, or sub chapters as well, in the book. So the letter is written to, and it is you can say addressed to his son Heather, and it's really lovely. I want to read it for you people. I write in these few pages that I think you need to know. What I tell you is known to everyone in these parts, but the effort it takes us to know what we know robs us of the energy to do what we must. You will understand what I write when you are in your 20s. By then, these words will not mean much. I hope we are at war, but we were not always at war. We have stumbled, but others have stumbled before us and recovered. Don't despair. We too will recover. And when we do, these words will tell you who we are and how you got here. You know the basics. You know that my grandfather rose from the soil to become a doctor, and that my father was a judge who died when I was in school. You know I studied at Yale before trying my hand at business back in Pakistan, only to fail. You know that then I restarted a new business again from zero. So that means it is a story of struggle. It is a story of constant belief in himself or in the person that he was, and that kind of story that you are going to read if you read this series of stories, actually the stories of the fatherland. Okay, so you don't know is how the country too transformed around me and what I learned along the way. I hope I help you understand your father. So it's really moving, because we all go through different phases in our life, and these phases give us some learning. These phases give us something to yearn, to wish, to struggle, to depend on something. So this is really something that I was looking forward. Here are some of the things, because my style of reading is that I read and I highlighted certain things that are really interesting for me or intriguing for me, or that sparks some controversy, that I usually underline. So here are something that is written about the spades, because the writer has an agricultural background. Here he is talking about the spades used in the Punjab, were designed for fashioning this hard, dry ground. They were not the straight spades with rounded tips used in the wet soils of Europe or East Asia to dig deep with each push stroke. Instead, they would only slice and scrape the earth every time they anchored down to the ground after being heaved over the farmer's head. Okay, so this is the whole description of this, and this is a long description that the writer has written here. It talks about the background of the writer, the writer's relationship with the soil, the writer's relationship with the land in which he is there, and his understanding is there, because it's not a superficial understanding, it's a deep-rooted understanding that we can see here. So here the writer talks about policy, that usually we are a victim of policies. So what a policy? A policy that invested in infrastructure that used energy more efficiently and made our lands more productive. A policy that allowed our family, effectively you and me, to rise out of poverty. So there the writer is talking about different policies that help them to come out of their poverty line. So here I can see, okay fine, I thought that there is some issue with the camera. Yeah, it's okay. Then the writer talks about What other important thing? Yeah, it's about the wind policy. He was talking about the different areas where he was living, Gujarat, as I have told you that he was from Gojra, and producing 3 megawatts of wind power. Of course, that creates an interest in engineering as well, because he live in that kind of environment. It is there. You know that we have also some connotations with energy, because in Pakistan there is always the issues with the energy policies. We were in the making of the dams, we never made them, some of that, especially the controversy related to Kalabagh Dam, and still the water shortages, and that is impending. And also you see that we have a huge electricity problem, and we have faced a lot of load shedding in the country, that might not be very much you can say experienced by the people in other countries that we have experienced here. So this all related to the writer tries to find out the background, that how the Britishers used different policies, and how we spend more money on acquiring the atomic energy for the purpose of making bombs, not for the purposes to get the energy for the positive purposes. So there is here and there you can find that connotations or that things as well that are related to that. Okay. There is a talk of dams, as I have said, because that is very much related to the Pakistanis, and the Pakistanis can understand that what is the importance of dams and what kind of controversies created around the dams. And recently we have a dam fund as well, too much of the surprise of the people all over the world, that the government or even the Chief Justice of the country was asking for the money from the people to build a dam. So how they manipulate the people on their needs, and the money that should have been spent on the welfare of the people is spent on making that things that might harm them. This is something. Now the last mail is there. So he discussed a number of things related to his family, his background, so these are the details, and interesting details, I might say, that it really gives us an insight into the life at that time, how the people were living, and how classes of the country or Pakistan or the United India were living, who were educated, who were broad-minded, and what was the style of living at that time. So I am just try to find something interesting to give you an to a read, okay? There is a chapter on Gojra, that his ancestral city, and there is a chapter on Mall Road and the writer's memories related to that. I too have a lot of memories with the Mall Road, and every generation of the Lahoris, means not Pakistanis if I might say, have some memories related to that. Let's connect review, because there was a phone call and I have to receive that, let's connect it. Really fond memories of the Mall Road, and I too have a lot of emotional feelings, because I used to go with my father to Mall Road, and the memories related to Feroz Sun Zoo, Qaidazam Library, Baghe Jinnah, they were very much a treasure for me. So I really love reading the whole thing, and beautiful style of writing the writer has. talking about social fabric, talking about society around us, talking about movie stars, talking about our favorite pastimes, and so all these things were there. So this is a very beautiful thing he has written here on page 59 in the chapter Hamad Piya. Islam is quite mathematical. One kalma, five namaz, 30 roza, 2.5% zakat, one hajj, and you are done. Nothing more. My concepts were clear. So I had read all this in Islamiyat. Anything that was not mathematically was not Islam for me. And so you know that how modern Islam is, how you can say mathematical in that way, because mathematics is the base of all the knowledge it is said, if I'm not wrong. So you know that so how modern Islam is, that is also there. Okay, I have to see again and again about it, because you know that it's a huge issue of space in my cell phone. A lot of pictures are there. So let's connect it with the book again. So I want to have something. Oh yeah, there is a cricket as well. And cricket is a part of the social fabric in Pakistan, and people love to watch cricket. It happens to be there. So although nowadays I'm not I'm hating cricket, you know, but still it's there. And his personal life is really interesting. When he went to America, what was his experiences there, and then how he started his work, his journey back home. That is there. And then comes and again and again, you know, that the interest has been created because the social, political, cultural instances are a lot, and the writer has connected his personal experiences with these experiences. You know that without the reference of history, without the reference of culture, without the reference of literature, without the reference of poetry, politics, nothing is complete. So that gives this book a very fabulous read, because there is a lot of you can say references to all these things in this book. And the writer has talked about the lawyers movement that started in Musharraf's era, and how we as a nation desperately need a hero. And here and there we try to find heroes amongst ourselves, and how we every time we are robbed, how every time we are deceived. That is also there. Okay, so I have to go. There is a bell outside. Let's connect after. I'm back again now with my review. That was something important that I want to discuss with you. Then there is a chapter, Love and God. It's a really an interesting chapter that you really like to read. And because anything that has a spiritual experience, that is always very interesting for me, you know that that gives you an insight into the spirituality of not only the other person but his or her experiences, that unique experiences, because I believe that every person has a unique experience with his or her relationship with Allah Almighty or God. I always take interest while writing the experiences of the people. They were there. Should I need to discuss something more important? So there is a lot about the Musharraf era in this book, that how we fought the war, and with America, the war on terrorism, that is called. let's discuss it some other time, because the war on terrorism is something that really destruct my country, our lives. We are never be the same again. So I really like to discuss it some other time. Now I'm almost half of the book is done, and then his own relationships, means his personal relationships with his friends, and that he has discussed. There is a you can say he has written about his friend's mother. That is really interesting to read, and I have few ideas I have written, because I write it like this, means my views, where I feel that either I agree with the writer, or I have certain views that are quite different from the writer. So I try to write it here and hear about his friend's mother. I have written that Khwaja's Imran, why mother's reaction was so normal. I too sometimes surprised at such things. Okay, so she was surprised at something, and because you know that human relationships are very complicated. So when you read it, then you get to know what it is all about. Okay. So here he has written, that is really I agree with that. So I want to share it with you as well. People change their opinion only if they need you or if they are afraid of you. And I have experienced this a lot, and myself, and now I believe in that. Otherwise people won't change. It's very hard. It's it's seldom that people change. People only change due to these two reasons: either they need you, or either they are afraid of you. So be one. Okay, so, and better the people need you. So that's really important. There are the life or fate of the elected prime ministers in Pakistan, about Nawaz Sharif, about Benazir, that how the cases are made upon them, and on physical grounds, how the political leaders are always targeted, and so it's there. Okay. There is a different things that I want to share, because he has written that a recent study in Pakistan showed that educated people were more accepting of suicide bombings and of Al-Qaeda and the Taliban than illiterate people. This is really very interesting thing. And I also come across a number of people who become an apologist to Taliban, and they are very educated. Our current prime minister is one such person, that these people are really apologetic towards Taliban, and this is, according to the writer, a direct influence of what we have sowed in the time of Zia, in the time of Musharraf, how we take things, means what the dictatorship has given to us. The dictatorship has given to us that flawed mind that is there, and that is in every facet of our society that we are right now. And prejudice is a very human failing, so I totally agree with that. Prejudice will thus reduce our productivity. If we have to win, we must become friendly. To become friendly, we must change our textbooks, and this is one thing we need to understand. And we sorry, again and again I have to distract, because I am all alone at home, and sometimes a phone call comes and sometimes someone comes. So I hope you bear with me, and we try to complete our review. And I'm really loving it, and I want to do it now, because I have been planning to do it since long. Okay. So this was something more important, that what is the role of the army in Pakistan. The writer has touched it barely. He did not go into long details, because the history of Pakistan is so replete with these things that I think that he can't go too long, because that he is sharing the stories, not a single, his focus is not a single thing, but although, yes, they are very much coherent and very much interlinked with each other, because it relates to our everyday life. Okay, so that is the secularism he discussed, because in Pakistan secularism is considered something non-religious, and the people have a very strange opinion about secularism. So the writer has also discussed it in the context of the state of Medina, and nowadays we are listening a lot about state of Medina and which kind of state it was. It was a secular state because everyone has the freedom to practice his or her own religion. So this is according to the writer, and quite you can say apt as well, because there is no you can say ban in Islam to anyone, because everyone is free in their own sphere, no matter of which religion they belong to. If we consider secularism from this perspective, from that point of view, I hope we can make our society a better society. Not from that perspective that it is anti-religious or something like this. It is not anti-religious. If we go deep into the concept, it is about the freedom. If it is about the okay, there is another thing. The writer has written, this is a small difference between a shop run by a servant and run by its rightful owners. Our state has always been run by its servants. It's very deep. It's very deep. Be the servants is bureaucracy, or be the servants is deep state, or be the servants is the people in uniform. We are always run by servants, not by the owners. So this is our dilemma that we are facing in Pakistan. Okay. It's a huge discussion on how the bureaucracy is involved in shaping up our country, what we are today. There is a mention of Bhagat Singh as well, who gave his life in Lahore for the freedom of Lahore. Could not be a hero because he was Bhagat Singh. He didn't have some Muslim name. So we don't celebrate him in the same way as we celebrate him, Ahmad Shah Abdali, as we celebrate other people. So our ancestors were mostly Jats and Rajputs, we as a Punjabis, majority of us. So they fought with Mughals, they became villains, and the Mughals, who were the Muslim rulers of Delhi, became heroes. So this is how our history is distorted. So there is a reference to that as well. There is a reference of Karachi, that what kind of city Karachi was in 60s. It is the only Asian country other than Japan that manufactured its own metal cutting lead was Pakistan. So this glory, and the glorious periods are always described, are all also described here. Then there is a mention of the Punjab University, that it has the honor of having been associated with three Nobel laureates, we never heard about two pre-partition laureates because they were not Muslims. The third, Abdul Salam, got his Nobel Prize as a Pakistani, but his name also not mentioned because he is also not a Muslim. In that way, because this religiosity is embedded somewhere in 80s and in 90s. It was not before in our country, so it was there. Very interesting details, very interesting details. The writer says, I wish for you to find your own identity and not to let government servants decide who you are. So this is the crux of all the things that we are facing in Pakistan. This is our story. And the writer also says, we are at root fashionable, artistic, poetic people and able to present complex thoughts in simple body shaking rhythms, but we are not allowed. So this is the dilemma. But the writer is hopeful here. He says that we will recover, we will then transform, and from the brand name of terror to one happening calm. So calm nation, it is called nation in English, but in Urdu it is calm. So the writer has finished his book or on the very positive and you can say optimistic note, that we will inshallah become a calm, we will be out of all these dilemmas and all these things. Okay, this was my first review on the YouTube and I hope you like it, although a bit of glitches were there, hopefully I will be doing more such reviews in coming days and weeks. Thank you everyone for being there. See you again. Allah Hafiz.